Hello, welcome everybody. Welcome to the fifth lecture in this module on critical thinking. You remember that in the last lecture, I had spoken to you about mind mapping and even shown you how to do a small mind map and explained how mind mapping is very much similar to the operation of the brain, and that is why it helps us think creatively, think critically. In this lecture today, we shall be talking about critical thinking in the field of engineering. Now, before I begin this, I would like us to briefly go back to one topic which would be very much essential in the present, in today's lecture, that is reflexive thinking. I did mention it briefly in the last lecture, but did not dwell much on it. I thought I should briefly tell you a little about reflexive thinking. Reflexive thinking is a kind of thinking, is a quality of thinking, which is very important in what is these days called qualitative research. Now, it involves understanding, it involves thinking about one's own thinking process. It involves a process of understanding one's feelings, acknowledging the baggage of assumptions and ideological bias one might have. Now, this is one very important point which we all have to take into account, we all have to give a lot of importance to as critical thinkers. That is, acknowledging the baggage of assumptions and ideological bias one might have. I would like you all to think, contemplate and tell, maybe in the forum we can discuss about it, about what an ideological baggage is. Would you agree with me if I tell you that every action of ours, every decision we take has an ideology behind it? Would you agree with me if I tell you that if you go to the supermarket and buy a certain kind of food, whether you choose organic food or you choose processed food, you go to a bookshop and there are two editions of the same book. One, a very glossy, good-looking, well-printed international edition, and one, a not very good-looking Indian edition, you are making an ideological choice at that point. If you are buying clothes in a shop, you are making a very big ideological choice. And each of these choices has a certain assumption behind it. Each of these choices has a certain belief structure behind it. Now, if all these small actions of ours involve ideological choices, involve assumptions, how can critical thinking not involve assumptions? How can critical thinking not involve ideological choices? That is where I would like you to think about the choices we have to make when, for example, we are building a dam. A choices we have to make, for example, when we are trying to building a kind of a structure. What are the implications this has for everybody? What are the implications it has for us as a nation? What are the implications it has for the different sections of the nation? Do we agree? Do we not agree? And then, once we are conscious of our biases, reflexive thinking means one has to understand how it involves, how it influences our judgment and our analysis, how it influences the conclusions we make about certain things, and maybe again, finally, we go back to our thinking, we go back to our feeling and reconsider, rethink what we have been thinking. Now, I would like you to come back to the field of engineering, critical thinking in the field of engineering, and we'll see how in so many different ways reflexive thinking becomes a part of critical thinking in the field of engineering. But before you begin, have a look at this. It says, cheers to all the people who can change their minds when presented with information that contradicts their beliefs. Would you think that there are very few such people? Would you think it is very difficult to change our mind eventually, even when we are presented with facts and arguments? But if you want to be a critical thinker, probably one has to. You have to try and change your beliefs. But still, cheers to the few people who can change, and cheers to all of you who will probably change once you go through this course. Now, critical thinking in the field of engineering involves the following. evaluating data. It involves recognizing contradictions. It involves analyzing assumptions. And it also involves evaluating different points of view. Evaluating a data involves judging, weighing facts, and seeing what would be right or wrong. Analyzing assumptions means analyzing concepts like, as I mentioned before, the concept of thinking of a dam, the concept of making a cooling system probably, the concept of making a diode degradable plates with which one can eat. How do you analyze such assumptions? How do you weigh such assumptions? How do you judge such assumptions? Sometimes in the assumptions we make, we might even find contradictions. Contradictions basically come in the form of different points of view. Contradictions also come in the form of ideological contradictions. I'm sure all of you are familiar with the kind of contradictions we have when, for example, we think of building a dam. If it is engineering marvel for a group of people, it is agricultural success for another group. But for the third group, it means losing their place of home, losing their home, losing their land, losing their culture, which has been built over a period of a decade, two decades, three decades, etc. And one has to function in the midst of these ideological choices. One has to make certain choices at one point of time, at every point of time, in fact, and decide finally that which is for the general good. But I would give you a word of caution. What is general good sometimes can become very difficult to understand, decipher, and even unearth. The final thing which is important for critical thinking in the field of engineering is evaluating points of view. And that is what I mentioned last. How valid is my point of view? How many people are benefiting from my point of view? The people who are being harmed, how great is their harm? The people who are being benefited, how much is the benefit? Is the benefit worth causing the harm? These are the things one has to evaluate. And these very integrally form part of what we have seen earlier as reflexive thinking. R.W. Paul and Elder L. have pointed out 8 factors which are very important for critical thinking for engineers. They say, whenever we think for a purpose within a point of view, based on assumptions leading to implications or consequences, we use data, we use facts and experience and make inferences and judgments. I would like you to think of these 8 factors as the cornerstone of critical thinking in the field of engineering. Let us briefly examine and look at these 8 points. The purpose. One has to think of why a certain project is being developed, who are the beneficiaries of this project, who wants this project to be developed, who are the beneficiaries financially, and is there enough of available technology to build it? Is it viable financially, etc.? One has to also consider the points of view. The point of view which you have or which you have been given at the point of designing this project, is that the only point of view available, or are there other points of views also? I'll narrate a very interesting incident at this point. There was an incident in Rajasthan, which has been reported in one of the textbooks. There was an engineer who suddenly thought he was building a factory, and he thought that for the workers, he has to, not for the workers, for the people in the nearby villages, he has to make water available at their homes. And he set up a plant, he made the water available, and suddenly pipelines were put and water started coming to homes. The next day he gets up, after it was all over, he gets up to expecting a huge reception, and he finds huge protests over there, women protesting. And he thought he was building these pipelines to help the women make sure that they don't have to go very far to fetch water. And there was these groups of women protesting, telling him, who asked you to build these? Did you take our point of view into account before you build this? This is the only time we had to go out with friends, to relax, to have some fun, to talk with our friends. And now by bringing water to our houses, you have taken away that little bit of time we had for ourselves also. The whole project had to be stopped at that point. This is a mention in a textbook which talks of how sometimes we make policies without considering whether the people for whom it is being made are being really benefited or not. What are the points of view? Are there alternative viewpoints also which we have not thought of? One has to be very careful of these factors while making decisions. And then these also involve making assumptions. We make assumptions about what is useful, but are we also thinking of the environmental risks it contains? Are we thinking of marketability factors? Are we thinking of whether a certain kind of project, innovation, a gadget is seriously making a dent, hampering, making a impact on the socio-cultural system we have lived in? One has to take those considerations also into account while doing some project. And finally, one has to think in terms of the available information. Is it free of bias? Is there any other source of information available which you have not tapped? We have to think in terms of the concepts which are used in the designing. Is there enough awareness of the competing models? Are you taking the best model which is best suited for that system? What are the implications of building this? And finally, what are the inferences that can be done, that can be made from the financial and about the financial and technological necessities of the people we are doing the project for? As I have been talking, you would notice that apart from the technical factors, apart from the engineering factors, in a field like this, one has to take into account very seriously the ethical points. One has to have intellectual humility and understand that even if you think something is important, somebody else may not think it is important. And if it is meant for the person who does not think it is important, you have to yield at that point, give way and say, if it is not important for you, this will not be done. One has to also keep in mind the varied priorities and see how whatever is being done can be channeled differently, deployed alternatively, or maybe not made at all. Now, these are the important things which form part of the critical thinking, the crux of critical thinking in the field of engineering. In the next lecture, I'll try to bring to you two case studies and we'll try and see how these different factors become operative in real life when a certain project has to be taken up, when certain very important innovations which impact the life of many are made. Hope you liked this lecture. Hope you have understood the important factors which will be very crucial for you as engineers to take into account while thinking of projects. And I also hope you will appreciate the next two case studies we'll take up in the next lecture. Thank you.